Overtime Sports. Overtime is a sports network focused on young talented athletes, a digital native for sports fans. We are changing the way millions play every day. Overtime is a distributed sports network. Instead of offering content through a single channel, Overtime program is also available on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Snapchat.
Romans 8, verse 31. If God is for us, who can be against us? That's a scripture of GOATs. My name is Mambo Ngobi Khize, and this is Overtime Sports.
Get to know him and how he grew up and the decisions that he's taken in sports. Very promising young player, very dedicated to his sport, and we're just gonna get to know him today. Just have a chat with the boy. Stay home, stay safe, and sanitize.
Sure,
man. Some good news we've heard about you these past couple of weeks, and even though it's been locked down and you haven't had a chance to do what you love and play the sport that you admire. You know, we just thought that we'd come here today and get to know you, the type of player that you are, because I'm sure a lot of people have seen you on the field, and but they don't know you personally. So we'd just like to get to know you. So one of the first questions that I'm going to ask is, who is Mambo Mkhize? Who is he, and what is his upbringing like?
Well, I was raised up in a place called Inanda, a township called Inanda. My upbringing wasn't the best, you know. I grew up under the influence of gangsterism, which was caused by poverty.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that's how I grew up. But then, sort of, as years went by, I grew wiser, you know. I changed as a person. As a youngster, as a little kid, I got up to a lot of mischief because of the influence around me.
Yes.
So, but I'm grateful for my mother, especially my parents, but especially my mother, taught me how to pray, how to rely on God, and how to live my life, you know, pleasing God. So, that sort of changed me, you know, sort of changed me a lot. So ever since, I've been growing my relationship with God, and I've been being a better person every single year.
Okay. So we can say basically that your mother's played a huge role in your life. She wasn't the best, but you know, she tried to make it the best for you at the time, and she's made it to the best for you up until where you are now. Just gotta give her a round of applause, just give her a hand, and you know, just thank her and thank God, of course. And so now that we know that you didn't have the best upbringing, but you're alive, you've become the player that you are today. So can you just give us a little bit of what motivated you, or how you got involved with rugby? And yeah, just give us basically how you got involved with rugby and where did your career take off?
Well, first of all, I used to do karate. As a little kid.
Yeah.
And then my friends started playing rugby. You know, but rugby wasn't a popular sport, especially in the township. Everyone played soccer.
Yeah.
So my friends playing rugby, and I was also like, I want to try this out. So I went to go train, and I started liking the sport. Luckily, I was a bit oversized for my age, so it was a bit easier for my age.
Yeah.
So as a 9 year old, I remember I started playing rugby when I was 9. I started playing under 14 as a 9 year old. So I was playing
that's quite impressive.
Yeah, but that wasn't really, it was really tough. But then later in the year, I remember I stepped down to under 10. So under 10, it was very easy. So
yeah.
So I enjoyed it.
Okay, cool. And How did you come to WBHS or Wavell Boys High School? How did you choose that school? Because I'm sure as a 9 year old, as growing up to under 14 level, you know, as you said, you started playing under 14 and then you went to under 10. And then as you grew gradually, how did you pick Wavell Boys out to be the school that you represent up until you reach under 18?
Let me start from the beginning. So obviously I played rugby in the township, and then playing development rugby, they gave me a scholarship to Clinic Prep.
Mm.
They gave me a scholarship, so I went there, Clinic Prep grade 5, when I was 10 years old.
Okay.
So I went there, started playing there, enjoyed my rugby, I grew a lot, and then I got scholarships
in various schools.
Well, first I wanted to come here to Wavell, but Clinwood High and Clinwood Prep had a good relationship.
Yes.
So they sort of influenced me to go to Clinwood High. So yeah. I went there for 2 years, grade 8 and 9. It wasn't my type of environment, you know. I didn't really get along with the people, and I didn't see myself growing as a person and as a rugby player. So I started thinking, you know, maybe it's time for change. So one of my friends here at Wavell told me, no, just come to Wavell. You're gonna enjoy it here.
Mm.
So I contacted Wavell. I'm like, because I'm a rugby player, I've done this and that, and I would love an opportunity to come to Wavell, a scholarship.
Mm.
So they took me in, interviewed me, and all. God's grace, they gave me a scholarship.
Yeah.
And I came here and things started working, started growing, and yeah, I mean, I don't regret it.
Mm. Wow, that's admirable. So, since you enjoyed playing in Wavell, because you the change of environment, and you enjoyed the environment more, where you felt like you were at home.
Yeah.
So, has that had a lot of influence on how you play?
Yes, it has. I feel more comfortable in the field playing with people that I get along with, you know, people that understand me as a person, you know. Yeah, and my coaches are really great.
They're
very patient with me, and they've taught me a lot.
Learned a lot, yeah.